This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And this video is going to be about the probability of mutually exclusive and non-mutually exclusive events. And this topic is a whole lot easier than it sounds. So let's get started. I've got a die. It's a cube. It's got six sides. One side has a one on it, one dot, then there's two dots, three dots, and there's four, five, and six. And I've got two events. Event A is throwing either a one or a three. And event B is throwing either a two or a four. Now I can figure out the probability of each of the events. The probability of A is the number of ways that A could happen, and since there are two different ways A could happen, either a 1 or a 3, it's going to be 2, divided by the number of different outcomes, which is 6. So the probability of A is 2 over 6, or 1 over 3. I can do the same thing for the probability of B. It's also got two different ways of happening, either a 2 or a 4. So the probability of B is also going to be 2 over 6, or 1 over 3. Now, if I want to find the probability of either A or B happening, then I can think of that as the probability of A union B. And let's just work this out logically and then come up with a formula for it. So the probability of A union B means I've got to get either a 1 or a 3, or a 2 or a 4. Now, there are four different ways that this could happen, 1, 3, 2, and 4. So the probability would be 4 over 6, the total number of outcomes. I could reduce that down to 2/3. And notice that really that's just the same as the probability of A plus the probability of B. So if I want a general formula, I can say the probability of the union of A or B, the probability of A happening or B happening, is going to equal the probability of A plus the probability of B. Now this works because A and B are what we call mutually exclusive events. Let me write that. Mutually exclusive events. Mutually exclusive events are events that don't have anything in common. I could think of this as a Venn diagram. If I had a Venn diagram, I would have two circles which don't overlap. One would be the circle for event A, with a 1 and a 3 in it. The other would be the circle for event B, with a 2 and a 4. So if we have mutually exclusive events, we can just add up their individual probabilities and get the probability of their union. Okay, now let's compare that to a different situation. So now I've got event A, and event A is 2, 4, or 6. And event B would be throwing a 4 or a 5 or a 6. Now notice I've got some overlap here. Both of these events, A and B, have a 4 in them and they have a 6 in them. In terms of a Venn diagram, let me do a Venn diagram down here. I would have two overlapping circles. Set A, or event A, is going to have a 2, and then in the overlapping area, I'll have a 4 and a 6, because event B is 4, 5, and 6. So I've got a 4 and a 6 in both of those areas. Now let's look at their individual probabilities, and then try finding the probability of A or B. So the probability of A is going to be the number of ways that A could happen. There are three different ways A could happen. So that's 3 over 6, or 1/2. The probability of B is going to be the number of ways that B could happen. There are three different ways that B could happen. So that's also 3 over 6, or 1/2. Now, if I use that formula that I had for mutually exclusive events, I would say that the probability of A union B, A or B, equals the probability of A plus the probability of B. Now, if I apply that formula, what that means is I would be adding the probability of A, which is 1/2, and the probability of B, which is 1/2. I'd be adding 1/2 and 1/2. That equals 1, or 100%. And that's like saying that there's a 100% certainty that either A or B will happen. But there isn't, because I might throw a 1, which is not in event A or event B, or I might throw a 3, which is not in event A or B. So there can't be a 100% probability. Here's what the problem is. Because I have that overlap, I'm actually including the probability of a 4 or a 6 two times, one with event A and one with event B. So what I want to do is get rid of one of those times when I have the probability of 4 or 6. So what I'm going to do is take this formula, the probability of A union B equals the probability of A plus the probability of B, and I'm going to subtract the probability of that intersection, the 4 and the 6. So that'll be the probability, I'm subtracting the probability of A intersect B. So let's work that out with the numbers we have. So the probability of A was 1/2. I'm going to use 3 over 6. It'll make it easier to do this. And the probability of B is also 3 over 6. Let's find the probability of A intersect B. Well, A intersect B is 4 and 6. So that's two different ways that that probability could, that A intersect B could happen. So that means I'm subtracting 2 divided by 6. If I do that, I'm going to get 3 over 6 plus 3 over 6 minus 2 over 6. That works out to 3 plus 3, which is 6, minus 2, which is 4, over 6, and that reduces down to 2/3. Let's look at this a different way and make sure it works. If I want the probability of either A or B, that means I'm looking for the probability of a 2 or a 4 or a 5 or a 6. Those are really the numbers I'm dealing with. There are four ways that could happen. There are six different total outcomes. So the probability of A or B of 2, 4, 5, or 6 happening is just 4 over 6 or 2/3. Which is what I get when I apply this formula. Okay, so now here's what that means in terms of how much you might have to memorize. If I have mutually exclusive events where there's no overlap, then since there's no overlap, the intersection of those two events is zero. So I can use this formula. I can say that the probability of those mutually exclusive events of A or B is the probability of A plus the probability of B minus the probability of their intersection, which is zero. Okay? If I have non-mutually exclusive events, like the ones I have here, with a 2, 4, and a 6, and then a 4, 5, and a 6, once again, I'll use this formula. The probability of A or B is equal to the probability of A plus the probability of B minus the probability of the intersection of A and B. Okay? So that's basically how this works. Run through this a couple of times. It seems like it's confusing until you just work through it and realize how logically it works out with actual numbers. Okay? So give it a try. Take care. I'll see you next time.